So, you want to bag your Vios Gen 3.5. Hello and welcome to a new video. This is actually an update video for our Vios Gen 3 catalog. If you haven't watched that video, click here or click down below. So, welcome. This is a Vios Gen 3.5 video. So, it's a fitting facelifted car for our facelifted catalog or updated catalog. Okay? Sa mga nakanood na ng Vios Gen 3, please stay kasi may mga nabago kami sa design na you might be interested to listen to. Sa mga hindi pa nakakapanood ng Vios Gen 3 catalog namin, welcome. And this will be the updated version. Ito yung susundin na rin. Okay? So, the Vios Gen 3.5, konting background lang, bakit 3.5 siya, hindi siya Vios Gen 3 na nabago. The Vios Gen 3.5 is actually a Thailand release model ng Vios, a facelifted release na hindi dumating sa Pilipinas. And now, our good friends from Thailand are exporting it to the Philippines. So you can actually convert your Vios front face and rear taillights to the 3.5 model and you get that really, you know, refreshed look ng 3.5 before it migrated to Gen 4. Which is, I personally like the 3.5 model. So, yun lang naman yung history nito, bakit may 3.5 pa tayo na mga models, facelifted models, okay? So ngayon, we're going to discuss on how to bag your Vios Gen 3 or Vios Gen 3.5, okay? So it's gonna get technical and educational. I need you to lend me your ears for this segment of the video. But before we head into that, please like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell icon for a notification, it really helps. And with that being said, let's get into the under chassis part of the video. Ano mga nabago? Malalaman natin in a bit. Alright, hello and welcome to the front suspension of the Vios Gen 3. Okay, or 3.5. They're the same car, facelifted version lang si 3.5. So, on this updated version of our catalog, we're just going to explain to you what type of bag ang aming ginamit sa harap ngayon. Yes, in fact, we are using a different type of airbag sa unahan. That's why we're making a new catalog video. Before we move on to the new bag section, let's actually quickly, briefly discuss kung anong type of suspension ito. This is a MacPherson type strut, okay? The shocks will pivot or iikot yung shocks natin sa axis ng ating shock body and in turn will be rotating the whole assembly. So medyo delikado siya kapag kayo ay mag-route ng hose line. Yun lang naman yung sinasabi ko lagi pag MacPherson type strut. So ngayon, going to the airbag, we are using actually what we call the Slim V2s. This is a slim bag, okay? As tall as our standard slim bag, pero as small or as thin as our super slims, pero they're still double bellows. So this is very good for compact cars kasi usually pag maliit yung kotse, Brads, maliit din yung clearances natin. Although yung mga standard bags naman namin pasok dito, pero we realized why not, you know, make the gaps to the wall bigger, okay? And so you can also fit wider wheels. Meron kasi kami mga instances na ang bababa ng mga drop na gusto ng mga clients, yung mga rolling nila mga mabababa pa. So we had to, you know, put spacers pa, camber pa tayo. With this bag, we can actually remove those spacers, cambers. You can just literally drop the car kasi the bags will be, you know, away from the wheel. The diameter of the plate is smaller, the diameter of the bag is smaller, pero the lifting capability of this is up to spec for compact cars. Yun ang gusto kong sabihin sa updated version ng ating airbag. But, moving on, of course, this is a catalog video. Just recapping, we actually will route the hose lines through the stock brake lines kasi the slack of that is actually OE, okay, or up to spec sa kasa. So, when you turn the steering wheel, the hose line will just follow the brake lines. That is actually computed na yung slack ng ating hose na yun, alright? So, moving up, nasa ilalim ng airbag yung ating hose line so that it pivots properly. Once again, MacPherson type strut. Okay, Slim V2s na bag, mas maliit, mas malano, as in lakas ng standard. Perfect for compact cars, but we won't use this for standard sedans or mga crossovers. Pang mga compact cars lang to, katulad ng Vios Gen 3. So, let's go to the backside of the car and quickly discuss kung anong bago sa likod ng Vios nating catalog na ito. Alright, hello and welcome to the rear suspension ng ating Vios Gen 3. Gen 3.5. On our updated catalog ngayon, nadi-discuss natin kung ano yung bagong ginawa namin for this Vios Gen 3. Okay? So ngayon, I have to reiterate na divorce suspension tayo sa likod ng ating Vios. Magkahiwalay ang ating bag or spring dati sa shocks. So this is actually a lot more difficult to pull off than kung magkasama sila. The other way is better. Mas maganda pang magkasama ang airbag dito. Mas madali siyang i-convert to air suspension. But we're not gonna talk about that. We're gonna talk about the divorce layout na meron tayo dito. Okay, so ngayon, moving to the airbag, ang ginagamit namin dati ay standard na slim bags. So kahit standard slim bag na ginagamit natin dati, pinapalo pa namin yung lower part ng subframe na to, yung kanyang spring catch. Kasi nga, pag nag-air out ka, sumasabit yung bag and that could possibly puncture the bag. Ngayon, what we did for this updated version is we actually use our super slim bags in the rear. So this will actually be, you know, syempre mas maliit yung kotse, mga Vios compact cars yan. So we realized we have to use bags for certain types of cars, which is a compact version of the slim. Okay, it's called the super slims, double velo pa rin siya. So it's actually easier to level. At the same time, maliit siya para hindi siya sumabit sa mga subframe area natin sa baba. In short, hindi mo na kailangan paluin yung pang-ilalim ng Vios mo. Alright, but one thing you need to note is pag lumiit ba yung bag, kaya ba ng bag yung kotse? Yes, this actually is powerful enough to lift the Vios up to 5 fingers, 6 fingers sa likod. So this is more than capable for the car's weight. But take note, we're just going to use this for compact cars. As I said sa unahan, pang-compact cars lang itong mga to. It's just a more non-invasive way to do your air suspension. Mas malinis. Plug and play lang yung spring catch. Hindi na kailangan putulin yung spring catch sa taas. Pasok lang kami ng pasok ng materials without removing materials from the stock car. And yun yung parang efficiency upgrade na ginawa natin for our catalog build. So, that's going to be it for the rear side. Let's go to the back side at i-discuss natin yung trunk layout ng ating Vios Gen 3 or Gen 3.5. Alright, hello and welcome sa rear trunk layout ng ating Vios Gen 3. As you can see, if you actually watch our previous catalog video ng Vios Gen 3, dalawang pump pa yung nandun sa amin. Actually, okay lang naman na single pump for Vios. Okay? Kasi magaan yung kotse. Hindi naman kailangan lagi na mataas yung pressure ng tangke. And the third generation is actually controllable na yung mga compressor natin. You can actually set your compressor status from 125 to 175 if naka Gen 3 module ka na. So yun yung parang update na ginawa namin sa likod ng trunk layout. Yan, yung compressor tools, pwede mo na ma-adjust yan. So, in short, pwedeng isang compressor na lang for the Vios. Don't really have to do dual compressors anymore. But, that's just the comparison dun sa dati. Ngayon, ano mga nadagdag na bago sa Gen 3 module or for this updated catalog? Of course, the first thing na mapapansin mo nag-iba na dito is, I don't know if you noticed, pero naglagay kami ng purge solenoid here to relieve the pressure sa hose line ng compressors to make sure the one-way valve is always closed. Other than that, yung kulay ng tangke at yung tema ng aming system is the same. It's a utilitarian layout, okay? Ibig sabihin ng utilitarian, magagamit mo pa rin yung utility ng kotse. So in short, we want it as spacious as possible, okay? Less parts na masisira like hard lines. Alam mo yun, of course, lahat ng wiring dapat fully insulated kasi pag naglagay ka ng gamit dyan, you don't want those wires being entangled to sa mga gamit na gagano na ilalagay mo. So, yun lang naman yung tema ng aming layout. It has to be good for daily use. Okay? So, in trunk space naman, well, maluwag ang likod ng Vios. You only took like 1/3 of the space and you still have a lot of space to put your bags in. And of course, spare tire still on the bottom kasi the client decided to go with the top layered top layout. Hindi rin kasi na ibababa yung back seat, so doesn't make sense to put it underneath kung hindi mo naman ma-access yung extra storage sa dulo. So kung hindi na ibababa yung back seat, this is optimal para sa daily use ng client. Alright, let's actually drop the car and let's see. Discuss the final thoughts sa Vios Gen 3.5 for this case, for the updated version. Let's go! Welcome to the outro of the video. The car is back on the floor. So we're gonna start up the car and we're going to... Okay, naka-rise on start yung kotse. It's a good way to start the video. Before we get into the details ng ating outro, konting recap lang. The car is actually sporting a new bag on the front. It has a MacPherson-type strut. Umiikot yung shocks. Pag kinakabig yung manibela, And ang bago sa catalog video natin ngayon is we're using a different type of bag called the Slim V2s. Standard slim bag siya na mas maliit ang diameter. So you can actually fit in wheels better for these types of cars and have better clearance for compact cars. At the same time, kasing lakas siya ng standard bag for lifting these types of cars. Sa likod naman, we have a divorce suspension, torsion beam layout, and we're using a super slim bag sa likod para hindi na kailangan paluin yung kaha natin, yung subframe, and then of course, it's enough to lift up the car. We're gonna show that in a bit. Ngayon, while we're at it, tingnan muna natin yung vehicle dynamics ng kotse. By dynamics, I mean, how does it perform air up? That's the age-old question. Gusto ko makita yung kotse maximum air up and maximum air out. So let's start with the front, sa harap. We are using stock suspensions nga pala for this car. We're not using any coilovers. For the stock suspension with the semi-slims or the slim V2s, we have around 3.5 fingers, 4-finger gap. Okay? Sa likod, we're actually at, yan, told you, 4 fingers. So the bags na nilagay naming bago dito, it's more than enough for the weight of the car. 4 fingers sa unahan. Let's see, I raised it up a bit. Sa likod, sa likod 4 fingers, sa harap, roughly around 4 fingers as well. Maltaas na yan, he can traverse through any locations na so far. And if you're familiar with our shop, napakalaki ng tarik dito papasok. So if you can go out safely using this height, you can probably technically cross a lot of, you know, obstacles already. But enough of that, drop natin yung kotse. Let's see the stance of the car. Okay, we all want to see it slammed to the floor. Connect lang ako sa app natin and... Alright, so I'm gonna step out of frame in a bit para makita nyo. And this is the drop of the car. Okay, we are using 17 by 7.5, not mistaken, RPF 1. Okay, we didn't have to put camber on this car. Wala siyang camber sa unahan, wala siyang camber sa likod. So you're looking at a very good offset, conservative, 205-45, if I'm not mistaken, yung goma. Alright, that's typical for 17s. For now, this is the aired-out stance ng kotse. Okay, fender to lips harap, fender to lips sa likod. That's really good. Okay, it really works well with the Vios. Ang Vios kasi pwede kang mas may wide lip wheels, sporty wheels. Tapos pag nag-air sus ka, bagay pa rin. Pwede kang sporty stance, you know, hot boy stance, useful stance, may daily stance na rin. So, very versatile platform. And then the Vios Gen 3.5 is well loved kasi mas maganda talaga itsura niya in terms of, you know, DRLs. So, mas maganda talaga yung mga flares ng 3.5 compared to the 3. I'm a bit biased kasi, I don't know, mahilig din ako sa Vios. So, anyway, is the Vios Gen 3.5 a good stance platform? Specifically, 3.5 models, air suspension, magandang wheels, it's gonna look really good. So, madami ka na nakikita sa scene. I'm pretty sure may nakita na kayo sa scene ng mga sobrang bababang, sobrang pipiki yung mga stance. Those are like Vios 3.5s na samples. But you can still pull off a really, really nice build like this one. Malinis lang. Okay? Ganda yung kulay ng kotse. Bright orange with those wheels. Ayos. Perfect drop. Daily use. Daily setup. Ayos yon. The goal of this car is to just take the owner from point A to point B and look pogi at the same time. So yun ang aking video catalog na updated for the Vios Gen 3.5. Hope you enjoyed that. Sana may natutunan kayo. At sana, sa mga nanood ng previous catalog, nakita niyo yung differences. Kasi that's really a game changer for us. We won't shoot a new video kung hindi significant yung binago namin. Diba? So that's going to be it for now. Okay? Before we go, please like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon for the notification. It really helps. And with that being said, it's been Cal from Fitment Engineering, and you're watching Fitment TV. And I'll see you on the next episode. Goodbye!